Hey, Jolanda at Dryer Buzz, and of course, 27 Answers. And this is where we take time to answer the one question that we get asked each and every day, whether it's inbox, email, comments. The question is, hey, Jolanda, how do we create buzz? Now, this is going to be a part three, which means if you miss part one, part two, don't worry, because you can filter the internet for hashtag 27Answers, or just scroll back wherever you just press play to get the other two. In this series of three podcasts, because it was a holiday, three podcasts, we've been really trying to focus in and hone in or work through word of mouth. Word of mouth. If you are in business, an entrepreneur, creative, you got a product, you're a vendor, you're selling, you are exchanging something for money, oftentimes, and you've probably said it a dozen times this week, word of mouth, right? If somebody's ever approached you about listing your business, advertising, promotions, shares, all those different things that I do on a norm, the first pushback that we oftentimes hear is we're good with word of mouth. So we talked about how word of mouth in and of itself has evolved when using social media for business. So I want to kind of wrap that up, but let me just reiterate a couple things that we talked about. Today, word of mouth is visual, meaning that you've got to have some images to go along with word of mouth. And using social media for business, a lot of times people are sharing photos, they're sharing audio, they're sharing videos. And for the most part, many who are out here selling on the internet don't oftentimes have the best photos, don't have videos. They aren't using, if you don't use traditional marketing, you've probably come to social media and missing the boat a little bit there. There's a gap, right? Again, you say, oh, well, I'm good with my followers. I'm good with this and that. Stop with the pushback. The one thing we said in one of the videos is stop arguing about marketing and go ahead and embrace it. But I really want to bring home the point that even word of mouth, just like everything else, has evolved. And with this one, even once you get your photos, your videos, your perfect audio, even once you have a couple of posts to go viral, at the end of the day, a lot of people still don't know, where did it come from? Where did those customers come from last week? Where did those sales come from while you were asleep, right? Because if you're selling online, you love waking up and you got a couple sales and outreach and inquiries and those kind of things. And unless you are at the end of the day, end of the week, end of the month, end of the year, at some point sitting down and doing an evaluation and deep diving into your numbers of really where your money is coming from. And I know you're not, because what else do I do each and every day? I talk with entrepreneurs about these sources, right? Where'd your money come from? What, how much did you make yesterday, last week, last month, last year? And why aren't you on a pattern? Why hasn't that become a pattern for you? And people are out here still trying to figure out. As I come back, put my for hire sign out, open up my Fiverr and all those different things again, All I had to do was to go back and look, well, how did it sell before? What drove the traffic here? What drove the traffic there? Where did the sales come from? You know, we just had a holiday. I'm like, okay, well, how did we do this holiday last year? When did we push out this content and that content? And how soon did we see some results of that? So as long as you're doing your deep dive and knowing, you don't have to worry about that. But I want to talk about, again, how word of mouth has evolved in social media. It's all about the referral. It's all about the reviews, okay? So on what platforms are you getting reviews? On what platforms is your last customer able to refer your next customer? Oftentimes, you'll get a referral from somebody who's never bought anything from you, but it is part of their influence. Like, say, for instance, I'm a blogger. I may not have ever gone to a particular festival simply because I may not have time, or maybe they didn't pay for an appearance, or maybe I didn't, that's not exactly my customers, or I didn't buy a vending booth for this, that, and the other. But still, being an information source or trying to maintain my status as an information source, I'm going to make certain referrals. I'm going to make sure that I share, publish certain content. I'm driving traffic there, and that doesn't mean, this is another thing in business, basically, as part of word of mouth. A lot of times when a business does get a new customer, they may not ask who referred them or how did they hear about them, you know? So unless you are out there surveying and asking those questions. Hey, how did you hear about us? Have you ever gone somewhere and they want to know, well, how did you hear about us, right? One of the expectations or one of the behaviors in being digital customers, when you go to a website or you go through a checkout process, they ask, how did you hear about us? Or they may give you, like, I'll do a social media campaign and I'll drop a code. So if I give like a percent off on this product or a free product here, there, and other, based on that code, I'm able to tell how they heard. Or having a referral program, an incentivized program of asking people to make a referral so they can either earn points or dollars. So that's another way, word of mouth. And we've gotten to a point now, you need to track word of mouth. So now, you know, you got your videos, you got your photos, because we told you in the last one, get with a photographer or start taking your own photos. We told you about some apps and things like that that we use in the descriptions of some of the posts that we share, and get you to that point. Word of mouth has evolved. It is definitely evolved, and there are some other behaviors that you need to take advantage of with digital customers. In each of our podcasts, we always talk about the ask. You've got to ask this information. You need, if you're going to do business, if you want to be really successful at what you're doing, you've got to ask. You've got to do your surveys. You need to know where customers are coming from. And like I said, it's the behavior of a customer not to necessarily offer that information up front. You may think that you're getting your business from this, that, or the other, but if you were to begin to ask your customers, how did you hear about us? You'd be surprised of where those referrals and that word of mouth, the sources of that word of mouth, because you could be thinking it's one thing. You could think that it's through your social media and all those posts that you're doing, and it may not even be the case. But unless you do a deep dive, stop at some point, not even a deep dive, but stop at some point and evaluate what you think is word of mouth, I guarantee you, you'd be a little bit surprised, okay? And if you're not asking, then you don't know. So start asking. If your process is fully completed online, if you're not at a point where you're still getting the emails, the inboxes, the contact, you know, that should be one of the first three questions you ask. First, of course, is how may we serve you, okay? But you know, in that, because you need a little bit more, you need to engage with the customer a little bit more. And then two, you want to reward. You really want to, because if you don't reward the sources of the referrals, they'll stop coming. They'll dry up, right? So make sure you ask. Make sure you ask, even in word of mouth. If word of mouth, you know that word of mouth is really working for you, make sure you ask, who's out there spreading the word? Because if you don't start to recognize and reward them, it's going to dry up. Because they think, just like you think your word of mouth is working for you, they think you know that business is coming from them. So find a way or place within what you're doing to ask, okay, so that you know where your money's coming in from. And then reward, offer some kind of incentive. At least go back and say, hey, thank you. Because I guarantee you, while you think word of mouth is working, while you think it's a particular source that's driving your business, it could be something that you don't know about. And you don't want to be in business at any level and not know what's working for you. So if I say to you, if you say to me that you're good with word of mouth, and then I ask you, well, where's your word coming from? What's the best aspect of your word of mouth? Who's your number one source? And you can't answer. You need to go and get the answers. All right, I got to get ready to push this stop button. Just wanted to wrap up word of mouth again. This is like part three, just talking about how word of mouth has evolved over the years, especially in using social media for a business. If you didn't use it on the traditional side, I hope you're loving it, how it works in social media. We're going to keep these podcasts going. You don't have to take notes. There are various books that we publish, ebooks, that you can download so that you can implement some of these best practices, okay? All right, I'm Yolanda at Dryer Buzz, 16-year blogger. The question I get asked often is, Yolanda, how can I create buzz? And let you know how to do that each and every day with a daily answer and a podcast. All you got to do is filter the entire internet with hashtag 27 answers.